Piscators. In this video, we're going to cover the basics of what you need to know for making contributions to Qiskit in terms of testing, linting, and documentation. So, first things first, all of the Qiskit repos have unit tests in them, and you're going to want to run those unit tests to check that any changes that you're making is not going to break existing functionality. To run all of the tests in Qiskit Terra, you can run tox-epy39 or different versions of Python, depending on what you have in your environment. And this command will run all of the tests in the whole of the Terra repo. This can take a really long time, but what you can do is use the second command if you want to just run tests for a specific file. So then you'll need to add the testing path to the file which has the test that you just want to run. This is a lot quicker. So what you might want to do is just run the tests for a single file while you're still developing your feature. And then just once or twice, you know, before you commit anything, any big changes and push things up, run the longer version to make sure you haven't accidentally broken things in other modules. If you don't want to do your testing in the terminal, you might want to run your tests within your IDE of choice. For me, that's VS Code. This is the setup that I like to use, so hence I'm going to show you how I do it. But essentially, if you go to this kind of test tube tab in your VS Code application, this will take you to a list of all the tests. And you can use this nice graphical interface to click through each of the tests and run each test individually. And then it will kind of run the test and show any errors directly in the code for you. To configure this, there are a few different steps that you need to do. But I think that it's a one-time setup pretty much. And it really makes your whole kind of testing and debugging strategy a lot easier in the long run. So to get the testing suite set up in your VS Code, what you're going to need to do is Command Shift and P to open the command line, or Control Shift, I think, if you're on a Windows machine. And then once you've opened this little Python terminal within VS Code, then you're going to want to type Python colon configure tests and run that. Then it's going to ask you to select the testing framework. In Qiskit, we use unit tests, so that's the one you're going to want to check. And then you're going to want to select which directory the test files live in. In Qiskit, all of the tests live inside the test directory, so you're going to want to select that one. And then you're going to want to check what testing file name pattern we use. This will help the VS Code testing framework to find the test files there and discover them so that you can actually run them. It looks for certain keywords like test within the file name. So we start all of our tests in Qiskit with test and then underscore. So we want to look for, we want to tell VS Code to look for anything with a test underscore and then the asterisk. Once you've done this, you should be able to go back to that testing tab on the left, like I showed you, and all the tests should show up nicely like that. If for some reason it's not working and the tests aren't showing up, there's a couple of common reasons for this. The first one is the most likely reason is that your VS Code application is not running the same Python environment as that you want it to. You can normally see in the bottom of the screen in somewhere on the bottom bar in VS Code which environment you're in. So if it's Conda, it will say and it will tell you the name of the Conda environment. If it's not the correct environment, so in this one, for example, I don't have Qiskit installed or I don't have the right dependencies installed, in that case, I'm going to want to set this environment to be my Qiskit development environment. So to do that, again, I open the VS Code terminal with Command-Shift-P. And this time, I'm going to do Python select interpreter. And then from there, it should show me a drop down of all of the environments that I have created on my machine that I want to access. Once you've done that, then you can go back and redo that testing discover process, and you should start to see those tests showing up there. As well as the testing suite that comes within VS Code, another feature that you might want to consider using, I use this a lot myself, but it is slightly more advanced, is the debug tab on VS Code. It's this one here, it's on the left-hand side. And what a debugger is a tool that is built into most IDEs like VS Code that basically let you add breakpoints into a test or anywhere within the code. And what those breakpoints do is they allow you to essentially run your test and then pause the running of the code at that point where you added that breakpoint. And from there, it's really easy to kind of inspect what's happening with the variables. You can check if certain errors are being thrown, if something is not getting passed through the way that you want. So this is really helpful for, pausing your runs, your tests as you're going through them, debugging those really tricky bugs, for example. This is a really helpful feature. You can see it adds the breakpoints here. They normally add it per line. It highlights there, and you get this kind of play button where you can pause and play things and then step through. It's kind of like a way to kind of stop and start the running of your code, like you would a YouTube video. Some general tips for writing tests. If you are contributing to Qiskit, you're going to want to add more tests or at least check that the tests that are currently there aren't breaking. So if you are writing new tests, the best thing for you to do is look at how other tests are written within that repository. Particularly in Qiskit, we have so many tests that you can look at for inspiration. All of our tests are named with test_filename. This is actually a requirement of unit tests. So if you don't name your test file or name the test itself with the word test at the start, you won't be able to run that test. If you, for example, are trying to look for tests that are relating to a certain piece of code, like VQE, you can search for the file or the test called test VQE. And this is kind of the naming convention that we use for most of our classes and functions within Qiskit. VS Code also has a shortcut. If you click Command P, you can search for file names. Make sure that you're using sensible names when you are writing those tests. As I said, they need to all start with the word test, but then give us a bit of information about what is actually being tested by that test. So for example, the file where all of the VQE tests are is called test VQE because that's what it's testing. You can also use some additional packages like the DDT package, which will enable you to run the same test with different inputs. Another way of doing this is using Python subtest. And this kind of reduces the amount of code you have to write. You don't have to duplicate the same test, 100 times with 100 different inputs. You can write the test once, and you can pass in different inputs to test different edge cases. And remember, you also probably want to be testing if the code that you're developing raises certain errors. You should also be testing that those errors are getting raised appropriately. You're not just testing your function works as expected, but you also want to test that your function throws an error and tells the user what's going wrong if they, for example, gave the wrong input. So make sure you're writing tests to show that something is erroring in the proper way. Okay, once you have testing out of the way, next up you're going to want to focus on linting. Linting basically means tidying up your code. Every repo, Qiskit included, has a specific style of code that they are enforcing within their repo. And linters help you to automatically check is something sticking to the style conventions of that project. The examples that I've shown you here work specifically for Qiskit Terra, but some of the other Terra repo, the other Qiskit repos might use slightly different linting processes as well as testing processes. So you're going to want to check the contributing guidelines to double check what you should be doing. For Terra specifically, what you're going to want to do first, you can run tox-elint. What this will do is it will run two different tools for linting. The first one is PyLint, which kind of checks kind of more strict formatting, like linting styles. And then it will also run a package called Black, which is more for kind of general formatting, like spaces and commas and things like that. If you run this and it throws errors, it will normally tell you what you need to fix. Like maybe you indented your Python code by too much, or your line was too long, or you missed out an end quote. It should tell you basic things like that. You can also run tox-eblack. What this will do is it will run the black checks, but it will also automatically fix those checks for you, which is really helpful rather than you going in and like fixing every line indentation or every new comma that you need. But just note that tox-eblack only runs black and fixes black. It doesn't run PyLint. So you still need to run tox-elint to get those PyLint checks as well, which do slightly different checks to the black ones. If you're lazy like me and you like VS Code, you can also do some initial configurations within your VS Code configuration file. That's known as the settings.json file in VS Code. And this will kind of automatically lint things for you while you're doing development work. So every time you save, it will make sure it's updating that linting for you. I've just stuck here a screenshot of how I have mine set up. For all of the work that I do in Qiskit, but you can also Google different setups that work for you in the specific project that you're working on. Next up, if you are making a user-facing change in your contribution, you are going to want to add a release note. This could be if you're fixing a bug, if you're adding a new feature, or making a change to an API. Anything that a user might, feasibly come across when they're using Qiskit, we should add a release note. Release notes get kind of compiled at release time, and then we release the document onto the documentation website. It's available at this link. And this is basically a compilation of all of the release notes that have gone into one release of Qiskit. So what you're going to want to do then in your repository, if you have a user-facing change, firstly, you need to install this package called Reno. And then once you have that installed, then you're going to want to use Reno to automatically generate the kind of framework for a release note. So to do this, you're going to want to say Reno new, and then a very, very short description with hyphens in between of what your release note is going to be about. So say new feature for VQE. And it needs to be hyphenated because this is going to become the file name of that release note. Once you've run this, it will kind of generate this file for you. And that hyphenated string will end up being in the title of your release note. And it kind of gives you some structure for whether you're adding a feature or a bug. So what you're going to want to do is remove anything that isn't relevant to you, and then add your own description. And it should be a concise explanation of what changes you have made in this code contribution. And even better, it would be great if you add a code example as well. You can, in that same file, look through all of the other release notes that people have been having, as well as any release notes from previous releases. So in Qiskit Terra, there's this folder called Release Notes. And within that, you can see for every past release, there is a subfolder that includes a whole host of different release notes. So you have lots of examples to refer to when you're writing your own. Next up, as well as a release note, you're also possibly going to want to make changes to any documentation. If you're changing something in a function, or maybe you're adding something new, every function that you create in Python, you're going to be required to add a doc string to it. And once you're doing that in the files itself, you might want to run the documentation build to test out how your documentation is actually getting pulled together. So for this process, what you're going to want to do in Qiskit Terra specifically, and again, this might differ for the other Qiskit repos, is you're going to want to move yourself into the Terra document, the docs folder, and then you're going to want to run the command make HTML. This process does take a long time, so because Terra is just such a big repository and there's so much documentation that needs to get all kind of pulled in and compiled together. So probably best to like run this, you know, only when you need to, and then go away and make a cup of tea and then come back in, you know, 20 minutes or so, and hopefully it will be finished by then. Once it has successfully run, you'll be able to move yourself into the build HTML folder. And then within that folder, you'll be able to see here a long list of a lot of different HTML files that have been automatically generated by this documentation build. Once you've had a look at those files, you can select any of those HTML files and open it in the browser of your choice, and you'll be able to see how the documentation looks once it's actually kind of formatted like the Qiskit documentation website. And there we have it. That is the basics of what you need to know about testing, linting, and documentation if you are making contributions to Qiskit. Thanks for watching.